गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मनोज भगत, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर दिग्रस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द टेंसेस। एज वी ऑल नो, देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ टेंसेस: प्रेजेंट टेंस, पास्ट टेंस एंड फ्यूचर टेंस। सो दिस टेंसेस हैव फोर सब टाइप्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द प्रेजेंट टेंस। The first part of the present tense, the first subtype of the present tense is simple present tense. Generally, friends, we use this tense for permanent situations and states, permanent truth or law of nature, for timetables, programs, reviews, sports, commentaries, dramatic narrative, etc. In this tense, we use P1 or P1 in bracket S/ES. Friends, when the subject of our sentence is I, we, you, they, and any other third person plural, then we must use P1. But when the subject of our sentence is he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we must use V1 along with the suffix S/ES. As we all know, S plus V plus O is very much important when we learn any type of grammar, but we are going to emphasize in this tenses only on verb, not on subject or not on object. Your subject will be there and your object will also be there. Only the verb will be changing now and then. We can see the example of simple present tense. First one is they work for an entire day. Number two, I play cricket. Number three, he watches TV. As I have told you earlier that when our subject is I, we, you, they, or any other third person plural, we have to use original form of the verb, that is P1. But when the subject of your sentence is he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we have to use original form of the verb along with the suffix S/ES. So in the third sentence, we have used he watches TV because the subject of this sentence is he. That's why we have used watch plus ES, that is watches. The second part of the present tense is present continuous tense. We use this tense for temporary situations, for actions happening at or around the moment of speaking, for repeated actions with always, expressing annoyance or criticism, or fixed arrangements in the near future, for changing or developing situations. In this tense, we use am, is, are plus before. So friends, in the simple present tense, we haven't used any type of auxiliary verb. But here, I am going to tell you about am, is, are. Means in our present continuous tense, we have to use am, is, are as auxiliary verbs plus V4. Means when am, is, are will be there, likewise ing will be there to our verb as suffix. So when our subject is I, we have to use am. But when the subject of our sentence is he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we have to use is. And if the subject of our sentence is we, you, they, or any other third person plural, we have to use are. We can see the example of these sentences. For example, I am taking dinner tonight. We are waiting for you. She is driving now. So I have told you earlier that when our subject is I, then we have to use am. When our subject is we, then we have to use are. And when our subject is she, we have to use is as our auxiliary verbs. Then the third part of our present tense is present perfect tense. In this tense, we use this tense for recently completed actions, for actions which happened at an unstated past time and are connected with the present, or personal experiences or changes which have happened, and for emphasis on number. In this tense, we use have, has plus P3. Means when the subject of our sentences is I, we, you, they, or any other third person plural, then we have to use have. We have to use have as auxiliary verbs. But if the subject of our sentence is he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we have to use has as our auxiliary verb. For example, she has cleaned her room. We have lost 10 kilos. I have taken a medicine. So I have already told you that when the subject of our sentence is I, we, you, he, I, we, you, they, or any other third person plural, then we have to use have as an auxiliary verb. But if the subject of our sentence is he, she, it, then we have to use has as an auxiliary verb. The fourth and last type of present tense, subtype of present tense is present perfect continuous tense. We use this tense for actions started in the past and continuing up to the present. For past actions, actions of certain duration, having visible results or effects in the present. For actions expressing anger, irritation, annoyance, explanation or criticism. For emphasis on duration, for example, for, since, how, long, etc. In this tense, we use have oblique has been plus before. So friends, when the subject of our sentence is I, we, you, they, and any other third person plural, then we have to use have been plus before. But when the subject of our sentence is he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we have to use has been plus before. For example, he has been writing a letter for 2 hours. Here, the subject of our sentence is he. That's why we have used has been. In the second sentence, we have been climbing. Here, the subject of our sentence is we. That's why we have used have been. And in the last sentence, I have been using my toothbrush. In this sentence, the subject of this sentence is I. That's why we have used have been. So, the second part of our tense is past tense. The first part, the first subtype of past tense is simple past tense. Friends, this tense is very simple. Simple in the sense that there is no need to use auxiliary verb. That's why means whatever our subject may be, we have to use simply the second form of verb. Generally, we use this tense for past actions which happened one after the other, for past habit or state, for actions which happened at a definite past time, although the time is not mentioned. As I have earlier told you that, in this tense, means there is no need to use auxiliary verbs, means whatever our subject may be, whatever the subject of our sentences may be, whether our subject is I, we, you, they, he, she, it, or any other third person singular or any other third person plural, we have to simply use second form of the verb, that is we to. We can see the examples of this tense. For example, she sealed the letter, they put a stamp, and I wrote that song. We have seen 3 sentences, but each of these sentences we have taken sealed, put, and wrote, means we have taken second form of the verb as our verb. Then the second subtypes of past tense is past continuous tense. Friends, we use this tense for action in the middle of happening at a started past time, for past actions in progress interrupted by another past actions. The shorter action is in the past simple and the longer in the past continuous, for 2 or more simultaneous past actions. In this tense, we use was, were plus before. So friends, we simply use was or were as our auxiliary verbs. But when the subject of our sentence is we, you, they, or any other third person plural, then we have to use were. But when the subject of our sentence is I, he, she, it, or any other third person singular, then we have to use was as our auxiliary verb. We can see the examples of this tense. For example, one, he was playing tennis. Here in this sentence, the subject of this sentence is he. That's why we have used was plus before. In the second sentence, we were swimming. The subject of this sentence is we. That's why we have used were as an auxiliary verb. And the last sentence is I was playing cricket. Likewise, the subject of this sentence is I. That's why we have used was as an auxiliary verb. The third subtypes of past tense is past perfect tense. We use this tense for past actions which occurred before another action or before a stated past time. For complete past action which had visible results in the past. For the past perfect is the past equivalent of the present perfect. In this tense, we use had plus V3. This tense is like the present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, we simply used have or has. Likewise, in this tense, we have to use had plus V3. This tense is also very simple, friend. Simple in the sense that whatever our subject may be, if the subject of our sentence is I, we, you, they, he, she, it, any other third person singular or plural, but we have to use had as an auxiliary verb in this tense. That's why this tense is very simple. We can see the example of this tense. She had left by the time I got there. I had tried to find his keys. They had played cricket. In each of these sentences, we have used had as an auxiliary verb. So that's why means there is no need to remember what type of auxiliary verb we have to use in this tense. That's why I have already told you that this tense is very simple as far as auxiliary verb is concerned. The fourth, or we can say the last part of the past tense, is past perfect continuous tense. Friends, we use this tense for action continuing over a period up to a specific time in the past. For past action of certain duration, which had visible results in the past. The past perfect continuous is the past. The past perfect continuous is the past equivalent of the present perfect continuous. So, friend, in this tense, we have to use had been plus before. Means this tense is very easy. This tense is also very easy. Very easy in the sense that whatever the subject of our sentences is, whether the subject of our sentence is I, we, you, they, he, she, it, any third person singular or any third person plural, whatever the subject may be, but we have to use simply had been as an auxiliary verb in this tense. So up to now means we have finished, means we are going to see the examples of this tense. For example, she had been working as a clerk for 10 years before she resigned. They had been walking in the rain. I had been working on the computer. In each of these tenses, we have used had been as our auxiliary verbs. And after that, we have used before. So, friends, up to now, we have completed two main tenses, present tense and past tense. So, go ahead with the last tense, that is future tense. The first subtype of future tense is simple future tense. We use this tense for decisions taken at the moment of speaking, for hopes, fears, threats, offers, promises, requests, commands, etc., for actions or predictions which may or may not happen in the future, for thing we are not sure about or haven't decided it. In this tense, we use shall or will plus V1. Friends, when our subject will be, when the subject of our sentence will be I or we, then we have to use simply shall. But when the subject of our sentences is you, he, she, it, they, any other third person singular or plural, we have to use will as our auxiliary verb. We can see the example of this tense is I shall turn on the light. I shall turn on the light. She will buy that dress. They will go home. So in all these sentences, we have used shall and will as our auxiliary verb. But as I have told you before, that when our subject is I or we, then we have to use shall. And when our subject rest of the others, then we have to use will. The second part or the second subtype of future tense is future continuous tense. We use this tense for actions intended to be performed in the near future, for planned actions or intentions, for evidence that something will definitely happen in the near future, for things we are sure about or we have already decided to do in the near future. In this tense, friends, we use this tense shall and will as shall oblique will be plus V4. When the subject of our sentence is I or we have to use shall be. Likewise, when the subjects of our sentences are you, he, she, it, they, any other third person singular or plural, then we must use will be. We can see the examples of this tense. She will be visiting her parents tomorrow. I shall be learning a course. They will be going to live in a new house. So friends, what we have done here, we have used in the second sentence, we have used shall be, because the subject of that sentence is I, and in both of these sentences, means in the first sentence and in the last sentence, we have used will be plus V4, because the subject of those sentences are she and they respectively. The third subtype of the future tense is future perfect tense. We use this tense for the actions in progress at a stated future time, for actions which are the result of routine. In this tense, we use shall oblique will have plus V3. When the subject of our sentence is I or we, then we have to use shall have. But when the subject of our sentences is you, he, she, it, they, any other third person singular or any other third person plural, then we have to use will have plus V3. For example, she will have come back by the end of July. I shall have finished until midnight. They will have gone. So friends, we have to remember one thing, that when the subject of our sentence is I or we have to use shall have. And when the subject of our sentences are rest of the subjects, then we have to use will have. The last subtype of the future tense is future perfect continuous tense. Friends, we use this tense for duration of an action which up to a certain time in the future. In this tense, we use shall oblique will have been plus V4. So friends, we have to remember one thing here also. When the subject of our sentence is I or we, then we have to use shall have been as an auxiliary verb. And when the subject of our sentences is you, he, she, it, they, or any other third person singular or any other third person plural, then we have to use will have been. For example, by the end of this year, she will have been working here for 2 years. I shall have been driving for 5 hours. They will have been playing cricket for 8 hours. So we have to remember one thing, that when the subject of our sentence is I or we, then we have to use shall have been and when the subject of our sentences are rest of the other subjects, then we have to use will have been. So friends, good luck. This is my maiden attempt on the YouTube. I hope that you will like my video, and I want to request all of you that do like my video, subscribe my YouTube video, and share to your near and dear ones. Thank you for watching me. Thank you, friends.